So this is another BMW NC3 engine, and sadly they are not except of problems, as you already know. And this time we have multiple cylinder misfire. That is a code that is going to affect many BMW's NC3 engines, and the solutions are going to vary. Multiple misfire is going to be caused for many different things. For many of you, the easiest way to know where the multiple cylinder misfire is happening or is coming from is the spark plugs. These are four spark plugs from Bang Wang of this BMW NC3 engine. I removed these spark plugs for one reason, to see how they are working. This is the best way you are going to find out where the problem could be on the multiple cylinder, or just misfire on only one cylinder. Remember, the misfire happens when there is not enough power coming from the specific cylinder, and this one, you know, as a consequence, it is not running smooth, or it is losing power once you are driving. Probably at that moment, the engine doesn't work stable enough, and then you're gonna get the check engine light on. When the misfire happens, the crankshaft and the camshaft, they work together to detect where is the slowest turn. So when cylinder number one is the one that is getting the misfire, at that moment when the turn is happening on cylinder number one, the camshaft and the crankshaft detect a slow turn, and that is when the vehicle detects the misfire specifically on cylinder number one. But when there is multiple misfire, is happening because the misfire on each cylinder could be not enough to call the specific cylinder, or it could be happening in different sectors at the same time. We can say the misfire is happening right now, but it's not happening in the next cycle, and then happening again, but next cycle doesn't happen. So the computer doesn't tell exactly it is happening on the specific cylinder, then it is possible that it's happening. But when you get the misfire on the specific cylinder, it's easy to repair it because you concentrate your problems on the cylinder number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, depending on the problem. But in this case, we have multiple cylinders, but also we have 1 to 5 cylinder misfire. So we have 5 cylinders that is getting misfire, and we have multiple cylinder misfire. Obviously, those 4 cylinders on bank 1 and the one on the bank 2, cylinder number 5, are getting the misfire and is getting the call of the multiple cylinder misfire. And that is the reason why we have the spark plugs right here. This will be the easiest way for you to tell where this problem can coming from. So the spark plug is going to tell you how good the engine is running or how bad the engine is running. It doesn't look like the spark plugs are in a worse condition possible, but it doesn't mean then the spark plugs are completely good either. So I did replace the spark plugs for some other old ones that I had and were in a good condition, and it didn't change at all. The engine is still making the same problem. Cylinder misfire from cylinder number 1 to cylinder number 4, those are the ones that I replaced. So where could be the problem? The problem could be in different areas. So in other videos I did in the past, I show you, then I tested the compression of each cylinder, and all the cylinders were low. In some cases, or one cylinder didn't have no compression. So that will be the next step to do before spending any more money. So what you wanna do is come and check the compression of each cylinder to see which one has the greatest compression. If all the cylinder compression are over 150 when the engine is cold, that means then the engine is working fine. But if the engine compression, the cylinder compression is lower, it could be then the engine is gonna need a repair. If the engine compression is lower than 100, that means that this engine is not good anymore. It could be an intake valve that is actually leaking the pressure, because the carbon of all these components of the PCB valves, the oil then goes inside the intake side of the engine, could be creating a lot of carbon, a lot of material, a lot of contamination to the seat of the valve, and this will not allow the valve to close completely to create the perfect compression. So for that, you are going to use an intake valve cleaner to release all the material that is inside those valves. You can do it without removing the engine with a little spray, and that will be not costly. But if that doesn't fix your engine and still you're getting low compression, that is going to mean then you have a bad engine, because the only way then your compression is going to get lost is going to be by the cylinders of the combustion chamber or the cylinder wall, because in the case of the exhaust side of the valves, they are not going to have this kind of problems, because they are just going to let the flow of the gases out. They are not going to have many problems. So if the compression doesn't get any better after spraying intake valve cleaner, there definitely is something internal on the engine is going to be expensive. Now, if you have all the compression in a good condition, you can say all the compressions of each cylinder are over 150 and still misfire is coming from the same cylinders, then it's possible then your coils could be bad. What you want to do in this case is swap the coils from the driver's side to the passenger side, and the passenger side to the driver's side. So that's what you're gonna do. You wanna swap them, depending on what is the misfire, depending on what the coil is. So you wanna swap them and see what happens. If the misfire changes position from 1 to 4 to 5 to 8, that means then all these spark plugs, these all coils are bad. But if the misfire doesn't go away, that means then we have a different problem. This could be injectors or fuel pump. So with a scan tool like this, you can actually check the fuel pump of the high pressure side to see how good the pressure is. If the pressure is very unstable or is lower than the other bank too, so because you have two different banks, you have bank one and bank two, and each bank is going to have a different fuel pump system. So you're gonna have a fuel pressure sensor on this side, and you're gonna have a fuel pressure sensor on that side. So if the pressure on this side is lower than the other one, it is possible then the fuel pump is bad, or one injector is leaking. It will be hard to know where the problem is, because there is no way to test each injector. There is no way, and there is no way to test the fuel pump functions, the performance of the fuel pump. It is a mechanical piece. So the only way to test it is by knowing how good the pressure is. And if you replace the fuel pump and the problem persists, it's possible then one of the injectors is leaking a lot of fuel, or all the injectors are leaking fuel. And that's the reason why the pressure is staying low and the misfire is happening in all the cylinders, because the fuel pump has to work harder to build the pressure. So then you replace all the injectors, and then probably that could be the cause of the multiple cylinder misfire. But what about if you replace all these components that I already talked about, and still you have multiple cylinder misfire? That would be the good question, right? Because many of you have done all this. Many of you have replaced spark plugs, coils, check compressions, clean the intake valves, replace fuel pumps, replace injectors. What will be the next thing? So the next thing will be, and that is something that you have to pay attention before doing all this, and that is vacuum leaks. Vacuum leaks are possible to make these kind of problems, multiple cylinder misfire. Vacuum leaks can happen because of the PCB valve is broken, because of the intake manifold seal is broken. The intake manifold could be broken, or it could be happening because there is a leak in any vacuum line that runs over the system. Sometimes it is not so easy to fix these problems, especially on these engines, because they have many components, and sometimes the problem could be further beyond than what you expect, more than just spark plugs. So you replace the spark plugs and doesn't do anything. So that is the reason why it's important to do a step-by-step process of inspection, of diagnostic of what could be the problem on this engine. And that is the reason why you have to have a scan tool to guide you the best. In this case, the scan tool doesn't tell me anything else but just multiple misfires. So what I wanna do? Just keep on investigating, try to get the real cause of the problem. I know already then we have spark plugs that weren't working right, I replaced them, but also I know then we have some vacuum leaks. PCB valve is not working perfectly, we have some leaks coming from the PCB valve, and we are going to check the compression to see what could be the problem. That is how you want to tell how bad is going to be your problem. So this is something to help you out in the seek of answers if you cannot find out multiple misfires, dry thermal function problems on your BMW. As you can see right now, it is not so easy. It is not just to replace parts. It is then you know what you wanna do and what are the steps then you are going to take to know where the problem is going to be. It won't be so easy if you don't have a scan tool, so please have a scan tool to perform any problems like this, because if the scan tool is not present, probably you can fix the problem by seeing videos here, seeing videos there, it's possible then you can fix the problem, but it will take a little longer and could be a little more expensive than what you expected. So that's the reason why scan tool is the most important component you have to have in order to fix these kind of problems. If you have any questions about this, you can feel free to comment below. But if you wanna go directly to me, go to Instagram and look for me, Francisco Maya YouTube, and just be ready to have a specific question that you have. That way I can give you the specific answer as soon as I have the chance. Make sure to have a scan tool and get the code, so that way you can forward to me and I can get the information to you the fastest, the better, right? And also, if you wanna help me out, you can check the description of the video. I have details how to send support to the channel. We can create content like this for you, why not, right? But if you don't wish to help us, subscribing to the channel will be more than enough. Following us on Instagram too. And this is all I have for you for the moment. Thank you for watching.